Good morning. My name is Emma, and I'm a first grader at Stuckey Elementary. My weather question is, how does a sandstorm form?
Oh, a sandstorm. We haven't seen one of these in a long time, but as we get into the summer months, we may see one. This is one that we were able to get some video of, and man, those are scary looking. Almost looks like it's out of a movie, right? Typically, we see these in the desert Southwest as we get into the summer months and we start developing thunderstorms. It's actually thunderstorms that help create these. Let's jump over to our weather graphics guys and talk about how these almost fake looking storms, sandstorms, develop. So let's take you down to the desert Southwest where they typically develop. In addition to being called sandstorms, the real strong ones are called habubs, actually originating from the Arabic meaning for hab, or originating from the description of how sandstorms were described in Sudan. So getting back to the ancient times of when these sandstorms would develop. All right, let's take you into the desert here. That's where they develop. You need to have the sand or that dust, and you need a thunderstorm to develop. It doesn't necessarily have to be producing rain, but a thunderstorm, when you have those updrafts and the downdrafts in those thunderstorms, it's the downdrafts that create initially a little bit of a dust, or that dust is stirred up in that outflow. And as that outflow moves away from the storm, the dust just grows and grows and grows. And that gust front is what propels that sand away from the thunderstorm, eventually looking like that huge wall of sand heading into cities and even sometimes into Phoenix, like we've seen before.